here on the islands. It's of course free at point of use, but we have already paid for it through our taxes during our working life. But if we need more medical specialist treatment, we have to go down to the mainland of Scotland. The grey building up there on the right with the flat roof is one of two primary schools we have here in Lerwick. Take children from age 5 to 11, and then also little nursery takes little tots from 2 to 5. So up to the right is our new Gilbert Graham Hospital, and over to the left is our health centre. This is very much the residential part of the town. An inlet of water you can see on your left is called Lerwick Bay, a wick or a bay. And the wick comes from the Viking Old Norse language, because that was the language that was spoken here on the islands up until about the end of the 1700s. Clickamin Broch. It's a circular building. It goes back to the Iron Age. A lot of the brochs, we have ruins of about 120 brochs throughout the island. And they were all Iron Age brochs. They were built somewhere from 200 BC until 400 AD. And they're completely circular. That building would have possibly been about 13 meters high. And it's double walled, and there's a stairway that runs between the two walls, so you can get right up to the top. And in fact, when we get to the site, the Jarlshof site down at Sumbra, we will be able to stand inside the remains of a broch. Over on the left is one of the biggest housing estates that we had built here way back in the late 60s, early 70s. And over on the right is more private housing. This roundabout here is the most northerly roundabout in Britain. And for this famous accolade, it was on a roundabout calendar. I think it was November. So we're just starting to move out into the countryside now. Still a few houses, just as I said, eventually just being built right up the hillside. A local community hall there on the left with the green roof. And all the blue and red houses we can see on the left. More social housing, and then all the private houses are up at the top, very big houses. And the furthest in house is where Jimmy Perez used to visit his friend, and you would see lovely panoramic views out over the bay.
Yeah.
And I believe one of his houses sold a couple of years ago for about £500,000. This used to be completely open countryside. I can remember it just being completely open. A little croft here, that's a small farm with a little house on it. But now, of course, it's changed considerably. A little building up on the left, the little tall building there is part of our meteorological station. It's manned on a 24-hour basis. There will be two in Britain. I presume it's because we're the most northerly one, and they put balloons up into the atmosphere to try and predict our weather, and they also check on the ozone layer as well. Down to the right is the sandy loch. We have over 1,000 lochs and lochheads throughout the islands. And of course it's fresh water and provides drinking water for, oh, it's got the Shetland ponies there over on the left. It provides water for the whole Lerwick, plus quite a big part of the mainland of Shetland. We have very soft water here, and I'm told it's particularly nice in a wee dram of whiskey. So we're just out into the countryside, and we start to see the rolling hills and lots of little sheep, our little lambs. They've most of them are brought up a couple of weeks, 3 weeks old. And you may notice there's something missing from the landscape.
Trees.
We have no trees in the landscape at all, so which is quite good because it means we can see for miles and miles. The reason being, we have three reasons really why we have no trees. We've over a quarter of a million sheep that roam the hillsides. We have lots of wind, and we have lots of salt spray. So even if they did grow and the sheep didn't eat them, they would then more Shetland ponies down to the left. Oh, there's two little foals as well. They come usually just the beginning of May, so they'll be a couple of weeks old. So that's really the reason why we don't have any trees. So the next little settlement here is called Gulberwick. And you can see the remains here of what would have been little croft houses, just the little rooms left and the little walls. And that would have been the enclosure where they would have grown their crops. And it's to stop the sheep getting in and eating the crops. But Gulberwick gets its name from supposedly a very wealthy Viking lady who wore lots of gold, and she was called Gulbera, hence the name Gulberwick, again the square inlet of water. Place names in Shetland, but 90% of all our place names go back to the Norse language, and this was because some Shetland sheep up there on the hillside to the right, you see a little black and white lamb there, that's the traditional colours. Shetland sheep come in many different colours, they come in very dark black colour, a mid brown, which we call Lerwick. Also white and spotty and all different markings. But anyway, we were invaded by the Vikings in the 9th century, so that's why we have a lot of place names that goes back to the Norse language. The Gaelic, Scottish Gaelic, has never been spoken on these islands. They're very hardy and they live on the hillside all year. They lamb on the hillside, they don't need any assistance. Over to the left is a quarry called the Brindister Quarry, and over on the right is the Brindister Lock. Little island in the middle, and it has the ruins of a rock. Island. It's old red sandstone that's quarried, and it is used to keep our roads in good condition, and also for making blocks to build houses. Of how much rain we've had. Often during the summer it will dry completely up, but this shows you that we've had lots of rain. And you can see that from all the very green landscape. next little settlement is called Quar. Q-U-E-R. Shetland is what they call the temperate marine climate. Because we have the Gulf Stream coming up from Mexico, it means that we don't have the very severe winters. But it also means we don't have very great summers either. The mean temperature is about 17 degrees. If we get 18 degrees, it's a heat wave. But normally it's probably about 15 degrees. You really need to be in the shelter because we always have a breeze or a wind here on the islands. I suppose that's quite understandable. We are just a rock in the middle of the North Sea. There's only, I think, about five or six pairs that still breed there. In Shetland, we call it the rain goose.